Welcome to this chair yoga class. It's a winter warming class, and let's get started with the centering. So finding yourself a comfortable seat, sit up nice and tall, legs coming out straight from your hips and knees over heels, shoulders over hips and ears over shoulders. Roll those shoulders up, back and down. Lengthen the back of your neck and bring your chin in slightly. Close your eyes or look downcast. And we'll begin with a centering visualization today. Feel your feet pressing into the earth, your sitting bones on the chair. And imagine a circle of light down about 3 feet below you, drawing energy up from that circle of light as if it's a lens, bringing earth energy into that lens and focusing it up into your body. Imagine a circle of light about 3 feet above your head. Again, imagine that like a lens focusing cosmic light down through that lens and into your body. Feel that energy meeting at your heart. It is said that at this time of year, the veil between the material and transcendent world is thinnest, and that is why we have so many sacred holidays in traditions all around the world at this time of year. So we're feeling the connection of the earth and the transcendent, bringing those two together in our heart at this time of year when we feel connection deepest to family and friends. And as you feel those energies mingling in your heart, take a deep breath and feel that energy rippling outward to fill the entire building that you're in, your home or your community. Take another deep breath and feel that energy rippling out to fill the entire state of Maryland or whatever state you're in. Feel that breath expanding, rippling out to fill the entire continent. And with the next breath, feel that energy of love rippling out to fill the entire world and everything in it and on it and above it. And if you like, one more deep breath, filling the entire cosmos. And feeling all that energy concentrated in your body. You are the center of the universe. And let's continue breathing and bringing that energy into our body. If you'd like to scoot forward on your chair, you can. And inhale, reaching out and up. Exhale, drawing that energy down into your heart. Inhale, scooping up earth energy, bringing it to the sky, bringing that cosmic energy down into your body. Scooping up earth energy, combining it with cosmic energy and bringing it down. Do one more here. And we know that this is a three-dimensional world. So I'm going to reach back with one hand and scoop that energy and bring it down. Let's rest the hand on the lower belly, reach back, scooping that energy. Hand comes down the midline and bring that energy into your belly. Reach back, spinal twist. Bring that energy down, clearing your chakra column, reaching back, scooping. Bringing energy and clearing into your body. We could do this the whole class, but we won't. But it's a great way to energize yourself, clearing sluggishness and replacing it with bright white light energy. So let's do one last spinal twist, reach back, grab that energy, bring it down. And just rest with your hands on your lower belly for a moment. And let's warm up the entire body. So sitting up nice and tall, we'll lower the chin to the chest and look up. And back to center. And let's bring one hand down and grab the bottom of your chair and bring your ear to the opposite shoulder. Inhale up, change sides, bring your hand to the bottom of your chair, pull, bring your ear to the other shoulder. Inhale up, we'll do a second set. Grab the bottom of your chair, pulling. Feel that lovely stretch from ear to shoulder. And come on back up and change sides. And back to center. Let's look over the shoulder. And back the other way. And back to center, let's circle the shoulders. And reverse those circles. And we're gonna make a figure eight, bringing one shoulder forward and then the other. Shoulder back and forward, making a figure eight. Anytime we do an infinity symbol, we are connecting again with that cosmic energy. So we're kind of drawing a figure eight with our shoulders. If you'd like to add some arms like you're swimming, you can do that. Kind of making that figure eight with your arms as well. And let's come to stillness. Feel the energy in your upper body and we'll circle back with one shoulder and then the other, doing a figure eight. Drawing a figure eight with our shoulders. If you'd like to add some arms and a backstroke. Bringing that shoulder forward, then the elbow, then the hand. It's a lovely upper chest and shoulder opener. Nice flowing breaths. And come to stillness. and we're going to move our rib cage. So imagine you're in a barrel and you're pressing the ribs out and around. So it's not so much moving from the hips as it is isolating the movement from your rib cage. This is a belly dance move if you want to feel like a belly dancer. Or you can just imagine you're running your rib cage around the inside of a barrel or a washing machine. So again, by opening up the ribs, we're deepening the breath, strengthening our lungs to keep our immune system strong and keep away those respiratory diseases. And let's circle back the other way. And if you can, you're isolating the rib cage. My sister is a professional belly dancer. She can do this really well. It takes practice. Let's come to stillness. Okay, we're going to do a lovely warm up for the hands, arms, shoulders, eyes, and brain. We've done this one before. Let's pick up one arm, soft fist, reaching out as far as you can with your thumb in front of you. Soft gaze at your thumb. We're going to open out one finger at a time. The head follows the thumb, the eyes follow, reaching around behind you as far as you can. Coming back in, pinky, ring finger, middle finger, pointer, soft gaze at your thumb. We're going to add to this, opening out one finger at a time, pointer, middle finger, ring finger, pinky, stretch back, and then turn your head to the opposite shoulder and nod three times. So we're getting our neck, our shoulders, our hands, and our brains, and our eyes all connected. Turn back at your hand, bring that hand in nice and slow, one finger curls in at a time, looking at your thumb in the soft gaze. One more variation. We're going to open out one finger at a time, following the thumb with our eyes and our head. This time we're going to push our hand away, fingers towards you, heel of the hand away. Turn your head and bow three times. Look back at your hand, straighten it. Come forward, one finger comes in at a time. Soft gaze at your thumb, soft gaze at the tip of your nose. Look at your thumb, tip of your nose, thumb, tip of your nose, and down. Take that in, other arm comes up, soft fist, soft gaze. Open out, pointer, middle finger, ring finger, pinky, reach all the way back. And come on forward, pinky, ring finger, middle finger, pointer, thumb. Second set. Spinal twist, turn your head to the opposite shoulder, three bows. Back to center, look over your shoulder, slowly bringing the fingers into a soft fist, looking at your thumb. Third variation, opening up the fingers one at a time, reaching back. Now press the heel of your hand away. Turn your head away from your hand, bow towards your opposite armpit. Feel that stretch in the shoulder and the neck. Turn to look at your hand, straighten it, and come on back in. Soft gaze at your thumb, down your nose, thumb, nose, thumb, nose, and then. One more, bring both thumbs up. So we'll look forward as we slowly open out and reach back as far as you can. Squeeze those shoulder blades, broaden the chest. Deep breath, spread the fingers wide, and then slowly curl back in. Soft gaze at your thumbs. Look at the tip of your nose, thumbs, nose, thumbs, nose, and down. Good work. Let's blow out our cheeks, big puffy cheeks. And release, inhale, big cheeks. And release, and one more time. And release. Good job. Let's move on to our legs. Let's pick up one knee if you like, or you can, you know, keep your foot on the floor if that doesn't work for you. Let's point and flex. Support this with your core. Keep your posture nice and tall. So the whole body is working, even as we focus on just our ankle. And circle the ankle. Circle back the other way. Let's open and close, warming up the knee. And draw circles with your foot, opening up the knee that way. And circle back the other way. My earring just popped off. And back to center. Mind if I just pick that up? Put that on the table. Thank you. Okay. And we'll pick up the other leg. And we'll point and flex. And again, you can put your foot on the floor if you need to and do it that way. But this gives us a little abdominal work at the same time. I love multitasking in a way that's really simple. And we'll circle the ankle. And circle back the other way. And one more point and flex. And then let's open and close at the knee. And let's draw circles. And you can do this on the floor if you need to. And circle back. And then take a breath. Let's pick up that first leg again. You can hug under the leg or hug the shin, giving that leg a nice hug into your body. And then you're going to pull that knee out to the side and hug it into your armpit. And you're going to bring the leg across as much as you can and pull it towards the other armpit, so you feel a little stretch in the outside of your leg. So it's not a spinal twist. And then let's pick up the other leg and give it a hug in. And then pull that knee towards your armpit. And then bring the leg across the other way. Pulling it towards your armpit and back and down. Let's scoot to the side of the chair and drop one leg down. And then reach back. Bring your hands to the floor behind you so you're trying to stretch the front of that leg. You can also turn sideways to show you reaching back, feeling the stretch in the front of that leg if you can. Plus, it's a bit of a back arc. Inhale back up. So again, maybe do it that way, just scooting a little bit, dropping that knee if you can, hands to the floor behind you, elbows hugged, chest high, reaching back until you feel a pull in the front of your thigh, if that's available to you. Inhale back up, bring the legs out nice and wide. And bring the hands to the floor and back. And we'll just do a little windshield wiper of the knees. Let's come back to center. Take a breath here. And let's come up to standing. And you can stand behind your chair. I'll stand at the side. We'll do some spinal warm-ups here. So you can hold on to your chair, rounding your knees, tucking your tailbone, rounding your back, inhaling, straightening, and stretching up. If you'd like to add an arm, as you round in, the elbow comes in, the back rounds. As you inhale, the elbow reaches up. Arm reaches up. If you can do two arms, I'm going to face you this way because if you're not holding the chair. Stretching up. So think cat and dog. We're rounding the tailbone, rounding the back. Inhaling, reaching. Again, it's perfectly okay to just do it this way. Holding onto the chair with two hands, or this way. Holding onto the chair with one hand or no hands. We're doing our standing cat and dog. Remember, the knees bend, the tailbone tucks as the back rounds, the knees straighten, the chest reaches up even if the arms do not. Nice full breaths, big stretch to whatever degree you are able, maybe deepening the bend and the stretch with each repetition as you warm up your body. One more. And back to center, holding onto the chair or Tadasana. Good job. So facing the chair, and you can be facing the back of your chair, we'll take the right leg and step it back, bend that knee, and then we'll open out into warrior two. So the knee is facing the chair, you're either holding on to the back of the chair with two hands. I'm sorry, if you're behind the chair, you're facing the chair this way. One knee out, one, two, the sides of the chair is in front of you, or at the side of the chair like I am. If you don't need the chair, both arms are out and you turn and look over your middle finger. Virabhadrasana two, warrior two. Deep breaths into your middle. Your power center. So if you need some energy, imagine that energy being focused from that disc below your feet, bringing earth energy up into your solar plexus. Imagine energy being sent down from that disc above your head, focusing cosmic energy into your solar plexus, your own personal energy center. Again, you can have one hand on the hip and one on the chair, or both on your hips. Honor where your body is today. And let's straighten that leg. And if you're at the side of the chair, you can come back like this. If you're behind the chair, toe heel yourself back to center. We'll do the other side. I'll pretend I'm behind the chair this time. Okay, so imagine I'm behind the chair. So one toe goes like this, the other foot step up, steps out. And then you're inhaling out or holding onto the chair with one or two arms. Turn, look over your middle finger. And draw that energy up from the earth. Focus that energy down from the cosmos. Bring it all right here into your solar plexus. And release and come back to the chair. So if you're behind the chair, just toes turn like that together. If the side of the chair, you're stepping back this way. All right, I'll pretend I'm behind the chair for you. Let's step out into goddess. So it's a wide step. Again, you could be holding onto the chair or bringing one or both arms up. And again, let's do a little breath. Let's reach out, stretch up. Exhale, press the knees and the elbows back. So this time the spine is straight. This time it's more bringing energy down into your core as you press the knees and elbows back, bringing your energy center online. Feel that sun shining from your midriff. So we're doing flows today, warming up the body because it's winter and we want to bring sunshine back into the world as we get towards the shortest day of the year. We want to bring warmth into our body as we move into a colder season. So that's why we're doing more warming stuff today, more movement. But again, just do as much or as little as feels right to you. Let's stay here, hold it. You can do a mudra. And middle finger together, ring finger together, or thumb and, let's do thumb and ring finger. And if you want a balancing pose, lift your heels, or just lift one heel at a time, and then the other, or lift both. Supporting with your core, shining from your solar plexus, creating sunshine. Big smile. Deep breaths. And release. And again, I'm gonna walk to the side of my chair so I can hold on. You could be behind your chair. We're gonna step one leg back and we're just gonna bring that leg up and down. Woo. Bring the heel towards your butt. So it's a bit of a balancing pose. You could just do fingers on the chair. Or you can bring your arms out to goddess. That's a little challenging. So just hanging on to the chair is fine. Maybe just one hand to goddess. And you feel that down the back of your thigh, perhaps, or the front of your thigh. So we'll change legs. Inhale, bringing one heel up towards your butt. And down. Stretching your glutes. Good job. And down. You want to turn that into a balancing pose. Bring one leg behind you. And again, you can just balance with your toes on the floor or lift that leg up. Find your drishti. You can reach forward with the one arm or both arms. And bring the hands back to the chair, bring the leg down, and bring the other leg back. So you can balance this way with your toes on the floor, find your drishti, or lift that leg up. Holding onto the chair, or one arm out, or both arms out. One side is always better than the other. And down. And one last balance here. This time we're going to step the first leg out, squeeze the elbows, begin to lift your chest and arc back. And that just challenges your balance just because your drishti is now up on the sky instead of below your horizon line. So we're getting a nice back arc here, nice lines from head to heel. And if you want to take off one arm, you can bring it to your sacrum. Or take off both arms and bring it to your sacrum. It's very challenging, so be real careful if you go for that. Really have to ground through the feet to make this one work. So that's connection to the earth and to the heavens. Nice deep breaths. Good job. Grab your chair before you come back up. Whew. Shake it out if you need to. Good job. You're doing great. So we'll send the other leg out, toes on the floor, firm legs. Begin to roll the shoulders back, lift the abdominals, lift the chest, arcing back to the degree that feels wonderful to you. Make sure the head doesn't collapse. Keep the neck nice and lifted. And then again, if you feel safe, you can drop an arm or bring that hand to your sacrum, really grounding through the feet and lifting up through the chest. Whew. It's a real challenge, bringing both hands to your sacrum if you feel safe. Be careful, maybe only one hand. And very slowly inhale back up, holding onto your chair, bring your feet back in and maybe a little marching in place with the hips doing a little sexy hip action here. You want your arms to go with it. You don't even have to take your toes off the floor, just lifting your heels. Again, you can be holding onto your chair. If you feel a little more energetic, you can pick your foot up off the floor. So again, we're doing warming actions today, but you could just be pedaling your heels or you could be marching, you could be holding on to the chair or moving your arms and hands. Good job. And slow it down. Come to Tadasana or holding onto the chair. One last pose before we sit down. We're going to do a downward facing dog. So bringing your hands to the back of your chair, the arm of your chair, or the seat of your chair, whatever works for you. Bend your knees and walk yourself back. Big stretch. Focus on lifting your tailbone and straightening your spine rather than your legs. Inhale, straighten, coming into a plank pose. reach your heels towards the floor, press your thighs back, your belly in, you're in Tadasana just on an angle. And one more time, bend your knees, press your hips back, reaching back into downward facing dog. Lift that tailbone and stretch from hip crease to top of head. And inhale, back to your chair, coming back to Tadasana in your chair. Taking in the good work that you did so far today. All right, we're gonna do some nice, fun spinal twists. Let's bring our hands together in choo-choo train, and we'll do some choo-choo train circles. And choo-choo train circles the other way. And then we're going to bring our elbows in one direction and our head in the other. And change sides. One more time, switching direction, shoulders one way, head the other. Back to center, shoulders one way, head the other. And last one. And back to center and take that in. I'm gonna do a bit of a side stretch here. We're gonna take one leg out and bring it in. Take the other leg out, bring it in. Take one arm out, bring it in. Take the other arm out and bring it in. Gonna take one leg and one arm out, bring it in. I think we did this last week. Other arm out and in. Both arms out, one leg in. Remember, you can stop anywhere along the continuum. And the last one is we're gonna do that and in. There's your side stretch and in. So stay with any variation you like. You could just be doing one arm at this point or one leg, or you could be doing this lovely side stretch. So again, we're doing a vinyasa, we're doing movement here because we want to warm up the body for winter. One more set, I hope you're having fun. And back to center. Probably feel your heart beating a little faster, your breath a little fuller. And let's go into a spinal twist. So we'll walk ourselves around to the side of our chair. This could be your pose, or you can choose to drop your knee or stretch your leg out straight. Inhale tall and walk yourself around to the back or side of your chair. Spinal twist here. Inhale back to center, bring that knee back in, flip that leg over, walk yourself to the center. And walk yourself over to the other corner of your chair, sitting up here, or dropping the knee, or stretching that leg back. Inhale tall and walk yourself around into a spinal twist, grabbing the chair to help you. and slowly unwind. Bring that knee back in, flip that foot over, walk yourself back to center. Inhale tall, exhale, slide yourself down into a nice, easy forward fold. And bring your hands to your thighs and roll your body up. Either grab the back of your chair or cross your arms behind you. Lift your chest, arc back. Inhale up, toe heel yourself back to center. If you need a blanket or a shawl or socks, grab whatever you need for warmth in Shavasana. As the weather chills, we want to make sure we stay warm, taking in the benefits of today's practice. So get settled in your chair and seated mountain pose. You can use the back of your chair for support. Let your awareness be drawn to any part of your body where there's still some movement or twitching or tension or discomfort. Exhale all those things away, using the power of attention to integrate the benefits of all that you've done in class. You can stay here as long as you like. When you're ready, begin to bring some movement into your fingers and toes. Gently circle the wrists and the ankles. Move your head from side to side. And gently move and stretch in whatever way feels good to you. I hope you enjoyed this vigorous, warming chair yoga class to celebrate winter. Namaste.